We greet you all that have joined us for this live broadcast here on the Shabbaton, here in Tershua community, as we gather in the precious name of Yahshua HaMashiach. If you're gathering in any other name, it is a false schism of identity when it comes to Yah. You can identify yourself as those of the lineage of Yisrael. You're full of deceit and lies. You have altered the phonics and the name of your Americanized name, Willie John to Obadiah, into Tisephaniah, and so on. Yeah. Yet you call upon one of the most pagan, atrocious lies that has ever been created in the annals of religion, a pagan lie of a hybrid. You call on your Baal, and you literally think you have power to repudiate what is of Yah and to resist the powers of darkness. You have no Uzza. You have no might, no strength, neither do you have the conscience of Yah, Yahshua HaMashiach. You can only have that Laba, the mind, the strength of Yah's character, only by the testimony of His power, that it goes beyond all of the philosophizing or intelligence of man to understand how one brings forth a zira, a seed, without any kind of copulation in our minds of stupidity. But He brought him forth by the excellence of His power, His might, because He is, and there is none like Him. No other one that has the authority, the might, the power. No one that has the brightness. No one that sends forth an excellent truth to a nation, a people that He has identified, that He has called, He has elected, and they are His born here. It is something that people always forget, that there is going to be a remnant of Yisrael that shall be Yahshua. These damnable lies in the devils of hell, telling everyone you're a Hebrew, you're Yisraelite, you're going to be saved, not so. He came to a house that was lost, and they still reject Him. They are more concerned about culture and history. This book is not a damn history book. It is a book of truth and knowledge and wisdom, understanding. It shows you the depravity of a people that, when they rejected the counsel of the writing of the scroll, then they were a people that were estranged from wisdom and knowledge, and they went after every kind of damn god there is. And you find that today, Yisrael, they're pursuing the god power. They're not pursuing truth. They're not seeking after truth. The minds are not sound. And so they generate this euphoric of flesh, and they identify, I am a Hebrew. It doesn't mean a damn thing. Because I can look at the condition of those that were Hebrews and see their condition. It was deplorable, wicked, vile. There was an insensitivity to Yah. And because one says he is a Hebrew, it doesn't mean a damn thing. Yitzhak was not the only Zira or Yaakov out of the seed of Abraham. Don't forget he had Ishmael as well. So it doesn't mean a damn thing. I'm going to preach, teach, whatever you consider it to be, it makes me no difference at all. Your language is crude. I know. I intend for it to be crude. This is a crude generation. They're crude against Yah. They speak against him with a verbose nature. They're verbose, the nature. And I frankly do not give a damn. I will not be gentle upon this wicked generation. I want to show us something today. I know what I said last week, but I'll get back. Don't worry. I got something when Yah began to weaken my heart. He doesn't do that by talking to me. He talked from the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. These are liars. I'm telling you, my ach, he is not speaking to this wicked generation. If we do not believe them that he has sent, we're not going to believe a damn thing if he spoke to them. I've heard those individuals say to me, well, you know, Yah says to me, laugh, son. I say, there is nowhere in the Torah. It is neath where he said to the Nabi, laugh and clap. And I'm quick to repudiate that. I'd say it is a lie. He did not speak to you with that. It is your own conscience, your mind. It is all your own preconceived, deceived condition of your mind. And you think that it gives you some kind of aggrandizing appearance or before others. And it propels you above the masses of the people. When Yah speaks, as our Zachin Yeremiah has been talking to us, even the cedars of Lebanon bows down. The heavens quake when he speaks. The earth trembles in the presence of Yah. And yet this mere flesh saying that Yah, they're damn gods. That filthy god of their greedy, fat, wicked bellies are speaking to them. But not the creator of all things. Their own wickedness of their conscience is speaking to them. When Yah has to open his mouth, it is not the most pleasurable experience that one can experience. When he spoke, even in the camp of Israel, they tremble and they feared Yah. And these bastards say that Yah speaks to them and they don't even tremble. They walk in defiance in their own wickedness. He is not speaking to this damn foolish generation. You reject the testimony of Yeshua, this Eduth. It is the power of Yah's witness unto Yisrael. He came to witness of the lat or the secretive knowledge of the Torah in the bosom of those in that time of Acharith in the last days, that he would identify his house. And Yeshua would know his house. Because it was a house that is receptive to the Torah of Yah. It refines us. His word is a consuming fire because he is a consuming fire. It is a fire that seethes in the belly of Yisrael. You cannot put it out. It burns and it churns. It has tremendous thermal units to it, Israel. So we're a time that the mind is not only been easily deceived, it is a leba, a conscience, a heart, the center of man's appetite, his pleasure, his delight, whereby the mind is being bewitched, whereby the demonic powers of hell that Yah has granted for a season. Do you hear me, Israel? That they are altering the very genetic structure of a man's conscience. And that is a fact. Yah has granted that to be. That they will believe a lie. That's why they buy their damn Jesus. That's why they buy. I'm not going to apologize. You can sit here with some kind of fearful nature. Damn Jesus. Damn their gods. Damn Baal. That their minds have been deceived by this anti-Hamashiach Ruach, the Spirit. It's not the Ruach of Yah. Yah is not just a Ruach, he is breath of life. You cannot have any life outside of his breath. Yair's Ruach. He is life. He is the substance of life. He is the power of life. He is the progenerator of living substance. And that's why you cannot, Gaal, you cannot redeem yourself without the wisdom of the Torah. Because it teaches you how to repent and bring the offering. That's why no man is going to buy a cell, and these damn beasts lay burdens upon the poor to buy silver. You are a coward jackass. You are a liar. Telling them to buy gold, that this is going to be their saving power. Well, Bill Gates and Mr. Rockefeller, or the Rockefeller clan, the Kennedys that made their monies off the backs of bruising and slavery and every kind of despicable mode, they are the ones that shall buy themselves into the kingdom. It's not coming by silver. We have not been redeemed that way. And these are liars. I want to bring some light to a few things today. It's vitally important. We greet you all that have joined us in this live broadcast on this Shabbat. What a beautiful Shabbaton. My body physically was ready to rest. Hallelujah. I have been laboring, and when I say laboring, believe me, I have been laboring. And I would have finished up the job yesterday. To my mistake, I did not buy any rich caps. And so I got it all completed except a few sheets. Why? Because I know that my ark, they labor. When I saw that tremendous load of wood that they were bringing in, that did not just find itself on the trailer. They had to hoist that and lift that, and to make sure that it was completed and done. So if they are willing to labor and to dispense that kind of energy for the cause that is greater than them, the physical dimension, they go beyond that, what am I? If you want to be great among Israel, then began to serve. I don't want nobody to serve me. I will serve you. How about that? So we greet you all that have joined us. Our Ach, George Davis there in Los Angeles with the group that's gathered with you, and all of our friends, Zohot, Marianne, and those that are gathered, scattered throughout the nations of the earth. We greet you all. Yeshua HaMashiach, mighty name. We do trust that Yah's riches will rest upon you all, and that his Ruach HaKodesh will fill you in the voidness whereby there is void in us. We don't need the Holy Ghost. We need Yah in us. Greater is he that is in me. That's why Yah said to Yeshua, tell them to fret not. It is vitally important that this substance of life in flesh must lay off this fleshly body. And then when that is done, I will send the breath of my power in the living testimony of Yeshua. You all see him, and yet you all turn away from him. You saw the miracles of Yah in that body of clay, in the power of his word, and you counted it as naught, just like they have done the testimonies of Yah. We see the testimonies of Yah, the great works. It doesn't mean a damn thing. We have a generation whose minds are philosophizing the things of Yah. It is more concerned about the creature, the flesh, and the aspects of the flesh than the things of Yah. So they can gather under all kinds of canopies, and then they can have a wonderful time according to the flesh. And they can talk about all kinds of things that are not essential to the damnable practices that they're walking in, their sins. They're transgressing the Torah. They're living like wicked dogs. And they will never even mention sin. And it is a fact. I've been around long enough, as long as any of you all in here. So I am not a schoolboy. I am always in school, but I am not a schoolboy. Hallelujah. I'm not a tithe. I'm a simple messenger of Yah. I've received the gift of his witness, Yeshua. We must understand, it's vital for us to understand, the day that Yeshua HaMashiach was impaled on that stake, there was a time that was implemented. We can see in the writings of Shaul, as there was an expectation for him to come. That is why this time of the season is so valuable for us. We put off this earthly tabernacle, its desires, its passions, its fulfillment. We abandon all of those things that we may appease our Abba, because we know that this earthly tabernacle shall be dissolved. It's going to go down to the depths of the grave. Sheol. It shall find itself returning back to the particles of dust that Yah made it from. And the skin worms, the maggots, shall consume it all. And that's just a fact. That is the truth. And so we began this period of time that is called Acharith. It is the last of the latter days of the end time. It is the exceeding far reaches of the end time, whereby the remnant of Yisrael, they are scattered to every nation. Not this damn wicked nation, America, or the Americas, or the islands that surround the Americas. They have been scattered to every nation under the sun. And the remnant proportion, because that is a promise unto Abraham, that his zero would be Rab. They would be great. They will have a magnificent excellence. And they shall reproduce. And it is equal imperative in every nation. That's why he's going to redeem 12,000 of those. He did not say out of the tribe of Reuben, 6,000. He did not say out of the tribe of Simeon, of Levi, 3,000. He said 12,000 that have not been scarred by this polluted religious conscience. That they are pure, they are virgins, or Bethullah, they are men that have abstained themselves. They are pure, their mind. And the power of the delivery of their words, not only is it strength, but it is the witness of their character. It is the witness of their substance as to whom that one is. We don't find that today, Yisrael. I don't give a damn how we look among ourselves, esteem ourselves, and make us think that we are great. That's why you gather in your lascivious conclaves and you promote each other's folly. Yeah. You ought not to be. We began a time called the Achrith, whereby there shall be forces of hell that shall go forth, and they shall mark. No man is not going to be able to buy. To have this chana, the power to redeem knowledge of Torah. He's not going to have the ability to understand the creative power, what Torah does in one. No man would be able to buy or gala, to sell, to be the redeemer of his house. To redeem the bayit of Yah from the very darkness of hell. When hell has unleashed its mandate that Yah commands. We know that the heart of the king is in the hands of Yah. And as he turns the rivers, the yans of water, so he turns the heart of the king. No man can redeem himself unless he has a mind that is allegiance unto the beast or the system that is diametrically opposed to Yah. I want to inject something here, my son. It is amazing that these liars will tell you that there will be a chip implanted in one's hand or their forehead. That's not what the Torah says. Yours says it shall be a mark, an oath, it shall be a mark. And when you think of this, these are the same beasts of hell that will tell you that there will be a nuclear holocaust. How do you even establish logistics in that kind of condition? Where the earth is so polluted, what will you grow? What can you grow? Where the cattle shall die by the millions. Where the damn hog, not hog, but hog spirit. Of course, that vile, unclean thing can eat anything and live. And where they will dine on swine meat. They will dine on the hope of this false, damnable, twisted thing we call Jesus and Lord and God. You hear me, Yisrael? I want to show us something today concerning the mark, concerning this. Oh, I know what I said last week, but there are times that I awaken in the morning and my mind is traveling this way, although I want to go this way. And at the last moment, there is something that inspires my inward parts. What? That what I read yesterday or the day before. And the swine, so of this spirit and the nature of darkness, it has gone into the minds of the swine. That's why Yeshua said, don't cast your pearls before this damn swine generation. You don't give that which is kadosh unto the damn dogs. Least they turn or got you and read you, try to tear you to the slithers of hell. And these are pigs today. They eat any kind of damn lie. They eat the Jesus lie, the Lord lie, the Baal lie. A pig will eat any damn thing. It makes no difference what it is. They eat it. They are unstable. They have no strength. They are not. They have no assurance at all. Hallelujah. Let me read this, and I want to show us something here in the book of Matthew. Matthew. Yeshua speaking in the 7th chapter. He says, "Shafat," or judge. Don't be a judge. That you will not be judged in your conditions and your situations. Now, I know how people have taken that to dispose of any kind of mishpatim. We need the judgment of Yah. It is what corrects us. Hallelujah. It is what corrects us. Yeah. We need to dine on the things that are proper and appropriate for our spiritual health. Hallelujah. That transcends into our natural health. We need to eat that which Yah has appointed for us to eat. He has appointed for us to dine from the Torah, from the law of wisdom, from the law of understanding, from the law of counsel, from the law of the Ruach, from the law of his fear. So he said, unless you have the spiritual capabilities, don't judge. I have that. I'm a spiritual man and I judge all things. And I don't give a damn how one judge me. He says, for with what judgment you judge, you shall be judged. And with what measure you cause that judgment to be carried out, it shall be also measured or returned unto you again. And he asks us why we see this small infraction in the eyes of our ark. And we do not even consider the atrocity in our own eyes, the beam in our own eyes. And how could you say to your Aka, let me correct you, let me straighten you, let me cast out a demon, and you got a damn Jesus demon in you, man? I have never bought into the lies of this corrupt and the corrupt teachings. Never. Yah did not talk to me. He kept me away from all of that. He did not allow me to embrace it. He never allowed me to embrace the prosperity lies. I knew it was a lie when I first heard it. He never allowed me to embrace those teachings. There were things he never allowed me to embrace. Oh, I see clearer every day why he did not allow. That then my mind become polluted. And then everything I teach is on the strength of that which was polluted. You can't get truth out of a lie. You can't get bitter water out of a sweet well. And you can't get sweet water out of a bitter well. Hallelujah. It is right, my friend. How do you say to you, let me get you straight and get you right? How can you tell him that? He says, you are a damn Hanif. You're a damn hypocrite. You're vile, wicked, repugnant. Did he call that one a hypocrite? Yes. He says, you hypocrite. You Hanif. You're a liar. You're a perverter of truth. He said, first of all, get your own act together according to the Torah. He says, when you get your heart right with Yah, by the power of the Ruach, then there is a clearness to your conscience. Then you understand and experience how to assist your act. Not every man's counsel is wise. Not every man's counsel is upright, Tomim, it is perfect, according to the construct of Torah. Not every man's counsel is of substance, and that's a fact. He says, first of all, in verse 6, he said, give not that which is kadosh unto the damn dogs. This is a generation of dogs, Yisrael. I will prove it out. It is a generation that is marked. And we think that the mark, certainly it is of substance in the identity that we think. That one is going and tattooing or putting a chip in you is far beyond that, Yisrael. It is a mind that is controlled by the diabolical scheme of hell. As my grandmother, I would hear the elders say, that's a marked child. You ever heard thoughts? Proverb? They would say, that girl is marked. You can see the mark on her. They knew she was destined for darkness, death, hell, whoredom, trouble. You're the oldest one in here. My Ema, you're shaking your head this way. So what are you saying? It's right? Talk so I can hear you. I can't fuss at you. All right. And they would say that one is marked. That one has a mark on him. The old conscience of the elders would congregate and say, she's gone. But believe me, that child is marked. And when they were here of the atrocities, their prophecy was sound. It was sure. What has happened, Yisrael? We got dogs. Yah says that his Reach, or the pastors, they're greedy dogs. He called them greedy dogs. They can't have enough. They despise the Torah of Yah. Some of these damn beasts, their hands are softer than a woman. There was a proverb in my days, it was softer than a baby's, I won't say that word, but softer than a baby's ass. I won't say the word, all right? They don't even know how to bend their back. They're afraid to sweat. The word ish identifies with the strength of masculinity. Not some kind of effeminate, erotic type of expression. Oh, you don't have to say, oh man, it's still the truth. I'm a student. I'm not a nahe, I'm not a boy. That doesn't mean I'm not a student. I'm a student. So he says that if he commands you not to give that which is kadosh to dogs, you think he's giving it to these dogs today? He's not giving these dogs a damn thing. And that's why they're drawing from this concept that is based upon the principles of lies. How does one call themselves a Hebrew? They've changed their name to Benjamin Obadiah Yisrael, and they call on a damn hybrid pagan Jesus. It's a damn lie. That alone ought to show you the fallacy and the fallacies of their teachings. It is right. That's why they don't like me. They know about me. They just don't like me. And that's all right. I'm glad they don't like me. You don't give that which is of substance unto a dog. Neither you cast the pearls of your other gems, the gifts, the precious, peculiar thing of Yah. You don't give that before the damned swines, the pigs. Unless they trample them under their feet and they turn again and they tear you to hell. You don't do that, Yisrael. Yah is not giving the power of his truth unto the swine generation. This is a generation of dogs and swines. They greet one another, what's up, dog? They call the female counterpart the very express appellative of a female, Kanizra, Kenai. It is the truth, man. They eat every kind of wind of lies and falsehood. They're Muslim one day, a Hebrew the next, they're Christian one day, and a damn fool the next day. They're damn Jesus thumper one day, and then their Lord God, and then they're tried to, in their convoluted mind, tried to present, yeah, they're cowards and they're afraid. They don't want the results that shall befall them. Damn Jesus, how about that? Make sure the coward gets that, the one that you sit under that talks about Jesus. I'm a warrior, and I like to fight. I love fighting. I fight me all the time. I take me down all the time. Do you understand? If you're not impelling yourself, your flesh, impel, destroy the lust, as Azakim brought out on Chafi Iman, as he brought out on Kippurah, we must destroy the element. Impel, impel. I know the word he used. We should impel the lust of our flesh and ruach and began to tomim, to become complete in the Torah of Yah through Yeshua HaMashiach, that we may present the right offering unto Yah. You think a swine can present the right offering unto Yah? Judge me, Yah. Yirmiyah said, correct me in thy judgment. Not in your anger, your wrath. Unless you bring me down to nothing. There's nothing that can be recuperated. We can play all we want to and think we're getting by. This is a generation of swines and pigs. And so if there is a nuclear holocaust, then probably one of the fewest of the animals that would be able to survive it are the raging roaming of swines throughout the earth. And when a man's belly is hungry, he'll eat anything. We don't want to eat the living Torah of Yah. Yeshua said, take, this is my body. It's going to be offered. It has been offered for you. Take it and eat. That is what Chana is. By eating this living substance, you can redeem yourself. By eating the substance of the Torah, no man is going to be able, under the system of hell that Yah shall allow. It shall oppress the mind. It shall suppress the mind. There shall be a mark in the mind of man that resists Yah. It will become anti-Hamashiach. It will plead. Let me ask you a question. This damn stupid thing we call Christianity and these ignorant beasts out here. Let me ask you a question now. Here it is. There are 2 billion Muslims. There's 1 billion Hindus and Sikhs of that religion. You got confusion. You got 2 billion Christians. Now, how is it, Yisrael, and a consortment of all other religions that don't give a damn about the book that they think they know? It says that he shall cause both great, rich, poor, and small, all men to receive the mark. How does one do that?
Come here, boy, I got a little chip I want to shoot at you.
And people buy those damn lies because it has such a kind of comical, what is the word I want to use? This type of folly and frivolity. It has showcase to it. It's like a theatrical event. And so they buy that. Oh, they're going to put a chip. Here's a chip like a grain of a rice. People buy those lies. This is an ignorant generation. So when a true messenger stand up, they say, oh, he doesn't know what he's talking about. I know what I'm saying. And they cannot refute my verbiage. That's why they don't challenge me. You understand? So how does a Muslim, what is a condition? Because they're crying for Jesus Christ. You think a Hindu is crying for Jesus Christ? No, my friend. You have deceived your own mind. You are deceived. You are bewitched. It's not that way. He shall cause all men that dwell upon the earth to receive this mark. Child, what is the purpose of that? There is only one thing, Yisrael. There is a remnant of the elect. That they have been sealed. And the enemy will kill. He will say, damn it, kill them all. Kill the babies as Herod commanded. Kill them all to destroy that redeemer, the one that is the Galal, that shall pay the price, that shall redeem their minds out of the darkness of hell. Our minds ponder every kind of dark illusion and delusion there is. We're such damn simple people, it doesn't take much to persuade us. And one of our most urgent enemies is this damn thing here, your own mind. That is the thing that gets you in trouble. No, it's not me. It's not my friend. It's not my neighbor. Noach has got me in trouble. I like you, man, and I don't like you, but I love you. If I don't love me, I can't love you. So it begins with me, so I must make sure that I'm refined according to Torah. And these are spirits that have gone forth in this Akharit that Yah has sent forth in these latter days. So there is no seriousness, no soberness. The Zakein reminded us that one of the most important elements that's missing, the gathering of the Zakein. And when they gather, everyone, I said to the Ark as we were gathering on Yom Kippur, I did 99.9% of the talking. Why? To make sure that the conversation maintains a legitimate order, a construct. That it will be seasoned. And so in our youthful state, in our older state, we tend to think, let me talk. Well, I said, Toute façon, what a damn shame. You sit there for 3-4 hours in front of the television. Television does all the talking. You don't say a damn thing. It is right. You don't say one damn thing. The television does all the talking. And so what a matter of God began to talk. Well, he's dominating. The television dominates your mind. It dominates your conscience. Even when children say, what's up? You're not dealing with some kind of inept individual that is stupid. He's ignorant. But he isn't stupid, you understand? So you let the television talk all the time. So listen to one that will bring forth an excellent of truth. Not every man has the ability and the capability to do that. But they've deceived themselves to think so. Well, I got questions. Shut your damn mouth. Listen. And then you will grow whereby you will not have questions. That's your problem. You can never satisfy a question. Because the foolish or the folly that's that. So look, did they question Yeshua? Did they question him? Did they question him often? Did it satisfy them? Did they walk with him? They all turned away and went their own way. So questions have not resolved one damn thing. It is the power to shemach ol Yisraya ichat. That's what we need to do. Damn your inquisitive minds. You don't know a damn thing that way. You're in class, you want to prove that you had a little sense of intelligence. May I ask a question? I never asked a question in school. Because I knew that everything, and I was an excellent student. I was an A student. As a young lad, they wanted to send me to a school for children with special ability and talent. And even at that age, in the 7th, 8th grade, I knew the condition of my Ema. She could not support that. And I did not want to go with these arrogant beasts. I love my simple environments. The camaraderie with those that we played, the community that I lived in. I knew. In the economic sense, even then, that it would not be the appropriate thing for me. I knew that. And I never asked questions. I've never asked a question concerning the book. Hallelujah. Yeshua didn't ask any questions of Yah. He pleased him in all things, didn't he? This is the mantle of the powers that be. There is only one agenda. Only one. There's a word that Yah used that he has, Tav. Tav, the upright. They are marked to escape. To escape his Ebro. The judgment. That is an insane judgment. His anger that is poured out like the raging Nile when the floods of waters of heaven pour upon it. And nothing in its way can impede it. His Ebra is a judgment of wrath that is insane. It's beyond that. He has marked the children of darkness. There must be a mark or a tav upon Yisrael that they shall escape this Ebra, the earth of Yah. And so there shall rise up out of the midst of the governments of the world their crop. We as a nation, we must walk under the Mishra, the government, which is the concept of Yah's heart. It is fair. It is just. The governments are not just. You see the folly and the phoniness of what we call the presidential race here in this nation. That Mr. Romney says that Mr. Obama, he is not a poor man. He's wealthy. And when he leave office in his lifespan, he will make, if he lives another 10 years, he will make $100 million plus.
Minimum. He will make minimum $10 million a year. He's what, 52? He will be a wealthy man in his old age. And that's a fact. So there is this deception that's there are those that despise the wealth and don't want anyone to get rich. We did it on our own. No man is an island. No man does one damn thing by himself. That's why Yisrael cannot do anything by himself. We are a body. We are a collective engine of power. And the powers of hell seeks to disperse that. That's why you must have men of authority and rule. Not oppress, but they must rule. They must govern the people by the mind of Yah. They must instruct them. That's why the gatherings, the Torah was read. And then after that was an understanding, even the brilliancy of the voice of the Kohan or the chief Kohan when he would read, it would cause the heart of that which Yah had instilled in man to come alive. And they would rise up and dance and sing. They were not morbid like some damn fools. Yah speaks, there's life. Words I speak, you're sure commanded. Your ruach, the spiritual. And it presents Yah. Yah is life. There is only one agenda and one mandate. You must seek out and find the true remnant of Yisrael. When he brought them out of Mizraim, did he destroy some in the wilderness? Sure he did. He caused them to fall with death. Well, I don't buy that well. Can I ask you a question? Was Korah, Dathan, and Abiram, were they all Hebrews? Sure. Were they all what we call Yisraelite? Did he kill them? Did he kill their babies? Did he kill their wives? He said, damn them all and damn their damn God. Kill them all. You challenge me. You challenge my messenger, Moshe. We have lost the regard of Yah's protocol and his process. And so it has opened the door for the engine of wickedness to rise up in us. And that is the mark. What is wickedness? It is a rasha, it is a nature that resists the Torah. Those elderly parents and the elders of that little poor community, they knew that that child was marked. And they did not put a red dot on their forehead like the Hindus. They did not tattoo them. Not at all. But they knew the child was marked. And in many incidents, it was a short time. You know, Willie John is dead. Someone shot him. You know, Betty Lou Bell, she got killed. Someone killed her. Oh, you know, Johnny Smith, he's in prison. He got life with 100 years. He's gonna die there, baby. That's how they talk. Because they could discern from character, characteristics, posture, demeanor, willingness, obedience, all of those characteristics were part of the identity process to know whereby they could discern that one, what kind of mark was on that child. And they were never wrong in their assessment. They were never wrong. So there is a mark that Yah placed. There's a mark that shall be, but it begins by the engine that runs everything in this earth. Yah has granted it unto the hands of Hashatan. He has granted it so, Yisrael. Let me prove that out. There are many that don't. This is one book. This is the Shefa. This is the scroll. This is the writings of Yah. And everything in this book speaks of him. Everything in this book is him. You understand, Yisrael? Let me read this, and I want you to go to a place in this book, all right? Hallelujah. It says here, I know I've read it before, and I will always read it. In the book of Lucas, Marcus Lucas. Hallelujah. One verse, chapter 4, and one verse here. Yeshua's encounter with the powers of hell. And that's what the enemy is doing today. It is taking us above the law. This is what he did now. Was Yeshua the Torah made flesh? Was he not the Dabarim of Yah, the Word made flesh? Yeah. Now, if he is the Word, what has Yah put in us? Hold that there, right? Everyone turn to Jeremiah. Just hold that. And turn to Jeremiah quickly. Jeremiah chapter 31 and verse 33. Look at what Yah says. Was Yeshua the Torah? Yes. Was he the word of Yah? Yes. Look what Yah says here in Jeremiah chapter 31. Verse 32. Yah says, but this shall be the Brits, the covenant, my allegiance, my alliance, my betroth. He said, this shall be the covenant that I will cause it to come alive. When Yah makes something, it is a bara. When something is made, everything he made was there life. Everything he made was life. Everything. Zakhen Yeravayah, he brought out unto us so explicitly that everything that Yah does, it comes out of the darkness. And there's a time where Bahoshach, darkness, and great darkness shall prevail. Our minds are full of darkness. Our thoughts are based upon principles of darkness. We respond to darkness. And then when the light shines with the oar, when the light of his tzedek shall shine, we shall see the new beginning of Yah. And the day is upon us, Yisrael, whether you bow or not. Yah says, this is what I will do. I will bara. He said, with only Beit Yisrael, with the house of Yisrael, with Beit Yisrael. He said, after those days, saith Yah, after the days of the impelling, after the days that the Torah has been tried by every extremity, he said, after those days, he said, I will put my Torah. Yes. I will put my law. Yeah. Yeshua said, if you dwell in me as I dwell in the Abba, then the Abba shall dwell in you. Are we in Yeshua? Yes. Then the Abba is in us, isn't he? Yeshua, Yah said, I will grant it to be, I will put my Torah in their inward parts. And he said, I will write, I will inscribe, I will hatab, I will take the ink horn of the ink writing. I will show you who this one with the ink horn is. I will, give me a moment. I want to show you something here today. I know what I said I was going to teach, but this will bless you, all right? This will make you fat here. And I want to be fat. I want to be obese when it comes to Yah. You understand? He said, I will put my Torah, I will hatab, I will write it in the lever. He said, I will be the Abba, not some damn God. And they shall be my A.M. My people, my nation, my elect. And he says, and they shall teach no more every man his neighbor, and every man his brother, saying, do you know Yah? Do you Yada Yah? Have you experienced him? Have you experienced Yah?
Oh, I'm not ashamed to say that. I've experienced him greater than any man. How do you know you've experienced him? Well, he always make himself known by one attribute, by judgment. So if you don't yada yah, if you don't know yah, you haven't been judged. He makes himself yada known. You perceive him because he said, you're a dirty little beast. You're a damn liar. For they shall all yada me, from the least of them to the greatest of them, saith Yah. I will forgive their own their iniquity. Iniquity is a willing desire and passion to transgress Torah, to defy it. I know that there are those that will say, iniquity is your backbiting, and oh, these are simply the hybrid deformities of one's mind when they reject Torah. Sin is a despising and a rejection, or the fesheth, despising, resisting the Torah of Yah. And so we see the little hybrid mannerisms and the characteristics. You're drinking, you're smoking, you're lusting. Hallelujah. For I will forgive their iniquity and I will remember their sins no more. So let me ask you, when we confess our sins, does he cast them away as far as the east from the west? Did not Zachariah Ramiah say, you know, we can distance, or we have somewhat of a conscience of how far the east is the west in this land, but how far is Yah's east from west? So that's when we get into the kingdom. Why in the hell will we need this in the kingdom? We're going to be like him, Yeshua HaMashiach, in the kingdom. So we cannot lift ourselves above what he has placed in us. And that's the mindset. That is the anti-Hamashiach mind. We'll establish our own Jesus. We got a white Jesus. We got a Jew Jesus. We got a black Jesus. We got a Korean Jesus. You would think these damn nincompoops that identify with a skin complexion, that have them a damn black God. You all get quiet because you're fearful. I'm not fearful. You feel what no man can do to me. You don't send no money anyway, so what difference does it make? How about that? And so you cannot alter my speech. And you certainly can't buy me for $260. As one said, I bought him off for $260. This fat pig, what he was. And he still has the messages on his website and sends me his newsletter. What a fool. What a jackass. He's not even a jackass. Because a jackass knows the master's messengers. They know who is sent of Yah. Hallelujah. He said, I shall put this in them. Yeshua dwells in Yisrael, the witness of that powerful testimony. It ought to dwell in us as a nation. And if it does not dwell in us, there is no living substance of Torah. There is no, not Chai, but Chayil. Chayil is different than Chai. Chai is life, but Chayil is one having the skill for strength. Like a virtuous woman, that nothing impedes them to fight the battle that is set before them. Not everyone is a warrior. You have soldiers, but not everyone was a warrior. Not everyone is willing to lead the charge. Not everyone was willing to go in battle. When I went in the military, I was an ignorant fool. But it was one thing that I was. And I knew that that was my obligation, my stupidity. I was ready. And when they trained me, I was ready. And I was one of the top-notch soldiers we had. When it came to the physical application, I wasn't going to let the boy from Philly outdo me. You think the cat from L.A., California, he's going to show his prowess greater than mine? He may have been stronger, but he would have known that he had a challenge there. You understand? And that was a fact. You're boasting in your damn flesh, man. No, that tenacity doesn't derive from flesh. That comes from a seat of death in one's bosom that from birth, Yah puts it there. You're what you are when Yah created you. He knew what you were. He said to Yerubbaal before you were formed in the belly, in the fetim, in the womb of your ima. I knew you, boy. I put my fire in you for birth. He knew that. That's right, Ima. Hallelujah. He knew him. He had elected him. He had commanded. He had commissioned. Had nothing to do with mama or daddy. Had nothing to do with their prayers. Our prayers are not saving us. Don't think it's going to save somebody else. As Granny would say, "Tain't not." Gwana, not going to. Gwana, do much to deliver you. How's it going to deliver someone else? Tain't not. That's the way they would say, "Tain't not." So as a young boy, I can recall that speech. Very apprehensive and comprehensive. Gwan from here, boy. Gwan on. Remember how they talked. Remember how they sat in the company of each other. You'd hear no clowning, quietness, seasoned talk. I remember that. I sat back as a young boy and look and watch. And that's the truth. Yah says he would put something in his people he would not thun. Was Yah sure made of the flesh? Did he come by an ish? Sure. Sure he did. He came to the seat of a woman, like we all have. Let me read one verse quickly in Matthew 2 here. It says, in Lucas 4. Turn back to Lucas 4. It says, and Yah sure was he being full. Tome. There is no room for anything else. He was full of the Ruach HaKodesh when he returned from Jordan. And it says he was led, he was commanded, he was sent forth on the path, on the halach, on the path. He was directed. He was led by the Ruach HaKodesh into the Midbar, the wilderness. We know the story. He was there 40 days, 40 days and 40 nights. He ate nothing. And it said that when those days had ended, he was hungry. And that's when the process began. There's a time of great trial. We are going through things that we think that it is beyond our ability to sustain the course that Yah command us to walk on. Look at Eyo. I want to read a little bit of his language to Yah. What he says to Yah. And we think that we are the only one that are going through these kinds of trials. That's silly. Your little trials here doesn't amount to a damn thing. When you have a mother on the continent of Africa with 12 children, her husband has died. She has to feed every day for bread and preventer. She gets water and they cannot bathe. Well, those are Africans. How the hell can they all be Africans? When you say you have Yahudah, when you have Dan, you have Naphtali, when you have God in this damn wicked nation, I despise their lies and their corruption. I despise it. Damn them all. I shut my mind. I don't allow them. You understand? He has put scattered the nation abroad. And so you're going to have to search and find them out. Did the princes of the world knew Yahshua when he came? No, sir. No, ma'am. For the Torah said, for if the princes of this world had known, if they had known that he was the HaMashiach, if they had understood the power that would be leased unto Yisrael, it said they would have never impelled the son of Yah. And if they knew us, they will never strike out at us, because they know there is judgment. Osen payday is coming after a while. Oh, the payday is coming after a while. Oh, it's coming, it's coming. And everyone that has committed atrocity against true Yisrael, there's a price to pay. There's a price to pay. That's why you that are true Yisraelites live quiet and shalom with every man. As much as you have opportunity to do right by every man, do tough. If he's hungry, feed him. But those of the house of Yisrael, you embrace them. You learn how to embrace. I was speaking to the young Ark. I said, my life as far as being dysfunctional, how dysfunctional could it be? But it did not alter my senses and the sensitivity for the house of Yisrael. You can use that damn cloak. I will not. I will, man. And my life was as dysfunctional as any mother, six babies by six different men. Did even meet the man that naturally called himself birthed me until I was nearly 54 years old. You that had mothers and fathers, your lives are more of a damnable despair and dysfunction than mine. And that's a fact. We're nutty, we're silly, we're full of folly. We don't give a damn, we're immature, we don't care. We don't love Yisrael. We love wickedness, we love the wicked. We sell Yisrael, not me. I will die for my ark. I'm a Uriah, I will die. I'm going to die anyway. So why not die? No greater love than this. And a man, I'm not going to let you stop me, ark. A man will lay down his life for a friend, for your neighbor, for Yisrael. We frankly don't give a damn. We're just like the world. We're wicked. We act like the world. We do like the world. And hell, we are as selfish as this damn wicked world. You see how the world has controlled you and taught you how to do all of that? You tell me that's not a mark? You tell me when that is threatened, you will not do what it takes to get the landlord, the credit lord, and all them on your side? Damn stupid generation. Well, Reach, if you did not use the language you use, you could draw more people. Hell, I'm not trying to draw anyone. That I'm trying to obfuscate and take advantage of his responsibility. No man comes unto the Abba unless he draws them. We got to reach the world for the Lord Jesus Christ. You make them twofold more the children of hell. And that's what they're doing. We're going to gather. We're going to have a meeting about survival and shooting guns. Man, what a damn shame. Sukkoth is a time, I don't care if it's two of us. We're going to fry fish if we eat it all. Just us two. We're going to make coleslaw. We're going to eat and we're going to dance. Teach a little bit, but it's about the celebration. It is a chaga, to dance, to eat, to celebrate, to eat the sweeties, the cookies. I know it's not tough for you, but it sure makes that belly say, my, 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 my. Yes, sir, I agree with that, Yosef. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. May not be the best thing for me, but it's going to taste better than any. It's going to taste better than bean sprouts. Talk to me. It's going to taste better and much better than barley juice.
Talk to me.
It's going to taste much better when it's fried
and baked. I don't want no baked potato, no, no, no.
Give me some wedges, fried, fatty, greasy, sweet potato pie, pound cake, nana pudding.
Give me all of that, oh, give me some of that.
I don't want no baked chicken, I want fried. That's right. That's right, mama. Clap them hands. I want that kind of chicken to make you take your shoes off and wiggle your feet, Israel. I don't want nothing stagnant. I'm not taking no stick and trying to grill no deer meat. I want the gravy and all the red wine sauce. I want it in there, in my deer meat. That's what I want. It's a time of great celebratory. It's all right to bake for those that want it baked. Bring mine's fried. Well, it's not excellent for you. I'm going to eat these 7 days like that. Hallelujah. And then on the eighth day, I'll just have a Shabbat and say, Yah, Toda. Can't wait for next year to do it again. Isn't that amazing? Folks don't bake fruit cakes every day, do they? You don't even get that until the season of darkness is upon you. They don't even bake turkeys. We bake turkeys around here all the time. They don't do that. They don't cook chitlins until the chitlin time comes. And that's a fact. Mom, I know you're going to make that. Emma Smith would make this cake. It was a fruity cake. I don't know what that thing was. Fruit bowl cake, whatever it was. Give me the whole fruit bowl cake. That's enough to last me to next year this time. How about that? It is an encroachment of hell, Yisrael, to destroy the living Torah. Here Yoshua had this great contingency of hell. The enemy did not know the exact. He knew the power of Torah. He knew that. And he knew that if he could try the speech and try this word, that he can catapult himself over Yah, then he would have an inroad to destroy and fight out who is the true remnant of Yisrael. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yet Yah says, you wicked child of hell, that shall not be. I will not allow that. Here in Lucas 4, one verse I want to read. Let me read something here. Hallelujah. It says here, skip down to, I don't want to read verse 3 because I have a message. I've worked on that thing for 6, 8, 9 months a year concerning what the stone is. If you understood that one word, it will bring such a tremendous revelation of truth. As he said in verse 3, let me read. And Hoshatan said unto him, if you be the son of Yah, command the stone that it may be made bread. See, the stone. We don't understand that. And one day Yah grants it to me, I will teach this with perfection. Verse 4. And Yoshua says unto him, it is written that man shall live not by bread alone, but by every word. Does it say every word? It says, "Kol every dabrim, every word of who? Of Yah." And so the enemy takes him up into a high mountain. He showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. He showed him America and Britain. He showed him in its form, its shape. And the devil said unto him, all this power will I give you and the honor of them. Does he say, for it is delivered? In order for something to be delivered, it has to be gotten from. He said, it is delivered, it is delivered, it is delivered to me. I want you to know that, boy. Oh, I know it doesn't speak as to how his verbiage was with Yeshua, because you little tender-ear purists will think, oh, he didn't say that to him. And we say all kinds of ill things to Yah constantly. He said, it is delivered unto me. And he said, I want to tell you something, boy. Unto whomsoever I will, I have the power to give it. And you know it's not a damn thing you can do. Because you know the Abba does everything by time, by season. And this is not the season for me to come down. That's why I'm taking you here. I'm taking you above the Torah of Yah. He takes our minds above the Torah of Yah. And to make us think in our own self-grandizing corruption that we have the wherewithal, we have the knowledge of all matters, and we don't have a damn thing. We don't have anything. He said, it's in my power to give, and I can give it. He said, if thou wilt therefore worship me, all shall be yours. That's what these liars are telling you. It's about food. What Revelation, Giuliano 13 is about, it is about a shaha. It is about worship. It is about the zabak. It is about the offerings. It is all about that. The whole writings of Revelation. It is a man that is brought under the delusion of hell to denounce Yah, to allow your mind to rise up against him, to mark that mind that is against your mind, and you rise up against that mind with all defiance. And that's what he tried to get Yahshua to do. He tries to alter, he tries to remove the very tenets of the Torah to cause you to alter what he says. Well, I know it says thou shalt keep the Sabbath, but the Sunday Sabbath. Had a fat bastard by the name of T.D. the Snake Dog Jakes. And I heard this bastard say, well, the Shabbat, the Sabbath is for the Jews. What in the hell is a Jew? If there is no J, it cannot be a Jew. If there is no J, it cannot be a Jew. It's a self-imposed identity of a people, thieves and robbers, and that's just the fact. You got these belligerent Negroes. Well, we are the Jews. I'm not a damn Jew. You don't know who is of the house of Yahuda. You tell me all of us here are the house of Yahuda, you're damn lying. They were a nation. He said, this is my my nation, my people. And so those of Yahuda may have married a woman of God, and that was a Naphtali, a daughter of Yosef, and one of Yosef of Asher. Binyamin may have married one of Nephtali, a Dan. I will do the teaching on the tribe of Dan from Revelation, all right? Don't worry. We can't even grasp the simple things. How are we going to grasp the things that are dynamic? How many of you all can do addition? Come on, let me see your hand. That's all right. I can add $20 plus 30. I know that's 50. How many of you all can do subtraction? Look at that. You move like a ball of fire. Mom, even you can do that. Cannot go around the Torah of Yah. That's all right. Okay, that's... How many of you all can do fractions? Add, multiply? Okay. How many do algebra? The hands are small. 3. And what about calculus? What about physics? That's amazing, isn't it? And you that do algebra and calculus and all that, you can understand some of the fundamentals of that. It's a fact. I know. Because we must constantly refresh ourselves in the Torah. Oh, yeah. We are forgetful people, are we not? So how are we going to tell the word what is appropriate for us and elevate ourselves over that and elevate our minds over that, whereby there is no discipline according to the Torah, that we present ourselves as the Most High. Any time you elevate yourself over Torah, you're saying that. So he tells the folks, I worship. He didn't say he worshiped. You know how they like to talk God, gods. I worship on Saturday. And they panned the audience, and you can tell the uneasiness of the people. Watch this. And I worship on Friday. They were a little perplexed on that one. And I worship on Thursday. And I worship on Wednesday. And I worship on Tuesday. And everybody just went crazy. He soothed them in their wickedness. That I'm above what Yah commands, the mitzvah. And I worship on Sunday. He didn't say worship. And I worship. And I worship on Sunday. I say, look at this fat, chitlin-eating, hog maw, bone-sucking devil. I've heard him say he like hot sauce on his chitlins, hog maws and all of that. And people buy that. And they will say to me, well, you're not the judge. You're a damn liar. Yeah. I judge everything. And if you don't judge, you're a coward. Yeah. Hallelujah. If you don't judge, you're not spiritual. Hallelujah. He says, if you will bow down and worship me, your short answer and said to him, he said, get behind me, Hashatan, for it is written that you should worship only Yah, your Abba, and him only shall you worship. Now, don't think this beast doesn't know Torah, the word. He knows the letter, but he doesn't know the Ruah. And he brought him to Yerushalayim, and he sat upon a pinnacle of the Beit of Yah. And if he said unto him, see, if he known who he was, he would have known. You know, this beast is searching. And he is searching to seek out Yisrael. He is. That's why he asked the question, if. You ever use the word if? If I had $1 million, I could do that. Folks would say, if I had $10,000, I'd send you $500. You would not send a damn nickel. If I was rich, if I was this, if I could gain the whole world. He said, if you be the son of Yah, then cast yourself down from here. Why did he challenge him like that? Can I show you in the book? Turn to Tehillim. Hold that right there. Turn to Tehillim. Hallelujah. Tehillim chapter 91. Tehillim 91 and verse 9. I want to begin there. It says, because you have made the Abba Yah, which is my refuge, even the Most High, your habitation. Was not Yah Yahshua's habitation? Was he not the Word? Did he not abide in the Word? Was not the Word abiding in him? Come on, Yisrael, I don't say anything to befuddle you. You don't have to answer my questions. I just do that. I do everything rhetorically. I will answer the question. I don't need you answering the question. Hallelujah. I don't need you to respond to me. But I want to show you the whole picture of the matter. This is us, Yisrael. There shall no evil befall you, neither shall any plague come nigh to your dwelling. For he shall give his Melekim charge over you to keep you in all the ways. They shall bear you up in the hand, lest you shall dash thy foot against the stone. He says in verse 10 in Matithiah chapter 4. For it is written, he shall give his Melekim charge over thee. Did I not just read that? He shall give them charge over you. For what? And in another hand they shall bear thee up. Lest at any time you shall dash your foot against a stone.
Who?
Is that just relegated to Yeshua? It is relegated to the house of Yisrael, where the Torah, what he has written in them, what dwells in their heart, what they abide in, and what abides in them, Yisrael. And a damn thing that we can do against us. You got these hordes of these fear mongers telling everyone to get silver and gold. You, Yisrael, don't buy no silver gold. Send me the money. And I will give you some silver that is greater than that tarnished mess. It's going to be corrupt because it's corrupt. Send me the money. I'll sell you something. I'll sell you redemption power. That's what I give you. I give you redemption in Yeshua. You put that weight upon a poor little woman in India. That's a Hebrew. That's of the lineage of Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. You put that weight on her to tell her to buy gold, and hell, she can't even buy bread. She eats the same thing, tea and bread, every day. And you put that weight on her, you are a bastard. You are a mamzer. You don't know Yah. You may know Jesus. You'd be surprised the men out there doing that. Someone sent me a video the other day, say, Reach, you need to look at this. I clicked it on. The man said, Mr. Obama's already got it in line to line everybody and put chips in. I clicked, I deleted it. I write him back. I said, don't send me this damn bullshit. That's what it is. And I put an exclamation mark right there. You don't have to talk like me. This is my mannerism. I don't want you to be like me. I don't care if you're discomfort with me. I said, it's a damn lie, man. They said that Mr. Bush had it. Mr. Clinton. They said Mr. Reagan had it. They said Mr. Carter had it. They're liars. This mark is greater than that, Yisrael. It's a mind that is marked. It descends from the Torah of Yah. It has a mind of descent. It battles, it fights. And in a time of mind, you know that this is the anti-Hamashiach spirit. When one yada and experience the name of Yeshua and they call on Jesus and Lord and God. When they call on the Deus or the Deus or the deities. When they call on a made-up image that was created by a damn convoluted, twisted mind, and that's what it was, to keep a people oppressed under great bondage and tell them it's fine, that's what it was, and give them an image of a damn faggot. You can paint the faggot black all you want to. He is still a damn faggot. You can paint him to have slanted eyes like a Chinese. He's still a damn faggot. You can paint him to look like he's Mexican. He's still a damn Mexican. You can paint him to look like he's Puerto Rican, he's still a Puerto Rican. He's still a damn faggot devil. And that's a fact. And these are men that think that they operate in the Ruach of Yah. They operate in the spirit of HaShatan, Yisrael. The one that shall be the anti-Hamashiach. He shall rise out of the community of people. His strength, his identity shall rise out of the community, the collective of the nations who will give credence unto him. Well, I believe it's going to be a man, but it's beyond being a physical man. You understand? I'll get to that in a moment, all right? If you, I don't care whether you bear with me or not. If you want truth, I will teach it to you simple. If you don't want it, don't listen. Don't come here. I'm not going to be shaken by this wicked generation for a few dollars because someone turned away from me. Hell, my whole family turned away from me. You think I'm in trouble because someone turns away from me? Hallelujah. I've had men tell me they love me and they turned away from me. So what? Hallelujah. It's a mind that is marked. It is the mind that has been created by him. If this beast had known that Yeshua was the son of Yah, he would have never. That's why he asked him, if, let me see if you are the writer or the right of this written Torah. Cast yourself down. I know what it says. David says he will give his Melechim charge over you to bear you up if you go down. So cast yourself down from this high place. What he was saying, the pinnacle represented the Torah. Cast yourself down from abiding in the strength, the confidence, and the assurance of the Torah. Cast the Torah down. This bandit said it's not worth anything. ridicule it, ostracize it, say it's not even worth the value that it was written on, say the Torah is of no substance. If you do that, and if you are hid in him, he will raise you up, just like he did David. He sinned, but he was still the apple of Yah's eye. We are sinned. It all comes short. Yah's great gadol, where minds do not even function in the reality of whom he is. When it does that, there is a continuous praise out of our lips. Yeah. Torah. Yeah. Torah. Yah, Torah, Yah. Torah, Yah, for Yeshua, the precious Lamb. Torah, Yah. Torah, Yah. Torah, Yah, for the dumb of Yeshua. I brought you for all he has done for me. I lift up Yeshua HaMashiach. Come on, Yisrael. Cast yourself down. That's why a tzaddik man, a righteous man, a just man, a perfect man, he falls. He falls seven times, and the wicked, the Rasha, the wicked, come in his stead. He fall prostrate before Yah, and he cries out. He may do it seven times a day. Yeah. And if he does it seven times, haven't he? That's the fall of a Sadiq man. He doesn't give his mind over unto sin, to fall to sin, and willingly practice disorder against the kingdom of God. No, he doesn't. He knows what is right to do. He does it with obliging Yah in all things. And that's a fact. Oh, I know how we've been taught that. I know what I've been taught to us. I've been around for a while, and I don't boast in that. I've seen the schisms and the skullduggery of men, greedy for money and riches. Oppress the people, especially the women. Oppress them and take advantage of them and use them. You don't hear these men talking about the sins of the nature of man, the sexual improprieties and wickedness. You don't hear that, do you? Because they're all full of it. They're all full of it. They're full of their own shysting. Hallelujah. Can I move a little farther here, Yisrael? You all allow me, as they would say in the old days, you allow me to do that. Well, I'm going to do it anyway, anyhow. There is something important here I want to read to you. Where is that? You see, I come in here and I don't even know where I want to go. I had a verse, but that's all right. I'll get back to what I was teaching. How about that? Let me inject this again from Gileana Revelation, chapter 13, verse 17. That is the catalyst, or that is the main strength of everything that we've been teaching and what I'm teaching today. It says in Revelation chapter 13, verse 17, it says, and that no. We understand, as we express the meaning of no, what it means in the Hebraic, the Aramaic, lo. It is absolutely no doubt. I will hear, and I've heard my Isha say to Zeriah, or the little ones, I said no. What does that mean? What I say no, I mean no. And Yah says that no man is going to be able to chana. No man is going to understand the origination of man and the purpose of Yah. When a man becomes that deluded and that polluted, he doesn't understand the originality of Yah. No man is going to be able to bar, to redeem oneself, to bar back. It is a lie that we've been taught from under the bosom of this whore. And as a young lad, I began to consciously ponder, how can that be, Yah? On your deathbed, there's a confession. You can't confess and get it right. I never bought that. Because I did like Eeyore did. I questioned Yah on that when I say, how is it? I said, I don't even know my natural father, Yah. I was a young man. I said, I don't even know my father. I'm estranged from him. In order for me to know him, I must first of all search the records. I got to go find the documents that identify who the man is. And once I identify who the man is, I must begin to seek after him to find out where he is. That's the only way. How are you going to on your deathbed cry, Yah save me? And you don't even know who Yah is. It was a lie that has been mothered in the bosom of a dirty whore. Because her strength is to draw you into the captivity that your mind shall be marked. I won't have time for this, all right? That your mind shall be marked. It is a mind that is obstinate. It is hardened with sin. It is a defiant mind. When one never changes, we hear the truth and our hearts are not softened and pricked. Something is twisted in your damn psyche. You're twisted. You're twisted. You have rushed the Torah of Yah. You hear things and you wrestle with it. You've wrestled that. That's why you have so many young men today unstable. So many women, they're unstable. They don't know what truth is. Truth is simple. And ye shall know the Torah, the truth. And it shall bera, it shall create in your free heart. All the things I used to do, I don't do them no more. Since Yah laid his hand on me, oh, you know the way I used to walk. I don't walk no more since your lady's hands on me. The places I used to go, I don't go no more. I don't do that. How about you? No, I'm not going to sing it the way you sing it, because I take you back to that old damnable church Christianity. How about that? Todah. So no man will be able to buy or to sell Gaal. You're not going to be able to redeem yourself or to avenge yourself unless you that have the mark, the Uth, the name of the beast, and the number of his name. Unless your mind, Yisraya, there are different definitives in the expression of the word mark and how it is utilized in Torah. Unless one has the mark, unless one's mind is shema, guarded by the gates of hell. Isn't that what HaShatan said to Yeshua? What Dawid said in Tehillim 91? If Yah has his hands on you, if he has guarded you, nothing can overtake you. I want to read a few verses here concerning the mark, all right? And tell me, is this a physical mark in one? Or this has to do with a chip? It says here in the book of Job, Job chapter 7, verse 19. Now this is this man confronting Yah. He's somewhat begging Yah, but he's also confronting Yah as to his conditions. Job chapter 7, verse 19, he says unto Yah, how long will you stay and not depart from me? How long are you going to allow this to persist? He said, how long will you do this and nor leave me alone till I swallow down my own saliva, my own spittle? You're not going to even allow me to swallow that down? He says, I have sinned. I know I've missed the way. I've come short. I have incurred the guilt of my actions. He said, what have I done to you? You hear that? I don't believe I want to talk like that. I'm not that bold, but he was a man that was perfect. He was complete in all of his ways. He was a man that he feared Yah, and he hated he hated Ra. He hated the spirit of evilness. He hated it in his children. He hated it in him. That's why his offering was continuous before Yah as he did it for his children. Look what he said. I have sinned. What have you done? What have I done to you? He says, oh, you Nafash, you are the preserver. You're the one that breathed upon me. You're the preserver of man. He say, why? Why? I'm not going to talk to him that way. There are things that I'm very conscientious of what I say. There are things I will not say. It's almost like a child asking daddy, why? Why you spank me? He says to Yah, why have you set me as a mark, as a mifkah? Why have you put this mark as a mark against you so that I am a burden even to myself? You tell me that this man, he perceived that you have set a mark on me, Yah, against you. I'm telling you, Yisrael, we're dealing with something of greater substance. You think the enemy is going to let his lats, his secretive, inquisitive ways known unto this wicked world? He's never done that. They talk about the new world order and the waters. Damn the new world order. I don't even see why nobody would spend time on that, man. You understand? I want the order of Yah in my life. There's always been a new world order. It's always been an order under the gates of hell. Hashatan said, this is mine. I've set my mark upon the nations. Every kind of lewdness, every kind of wickedness, every kind of reprobate thing, that's his mark. When you mark a perfect man, you will mark a perfect man, a man that is complete in the Torah of Yah. You will know that that man's, it is shalom. It's a great shalom with that man. Because he walks upright. There's a mark, Yisrael. It doesn't have a damn thing to do with the chip being put in your body. There's a mind that is marked. It has been marked. It says that the wicked go astray. They go astray even from the womb. When they are born, they are marked. Yes. Hallelujah. They go astray from the Torah of Yah. Yes. And the conscience of that. And so we got all these books, the Kindler Hayes, and these lying bastards getting rich. It is not so. They're lies. It's not the truth, Yisrael. He said, why have you set your mark upon me, Yah, so that I am even a burden to myself? Now we see the mark of hell. It is of great oppression, suppression, our minds. Listen to me, Yisrael, how often we really think about Yah? Do we really meditate upon the Torah day and night like that we? Or we lie to ourselves and say we do? Because we want to believe that we are much greater than someone else. How stupid. Our minds ponder all kinds of matters that are not relevant for our spiritual growth. You're a damn liar. I don't care what you say, because I will show you if you meditate that way. It's one thing when a man meditates upon the Torah, Yah. When you see that man, you know you see a man of strength and character. His walk denotes that. His whole demeanor denotes character and strength. When he walks in a place, everyone says, who is that man? You understand. You talk that talk to those that you think you can impress. But don't talk it to me. You understand? Don't talk that to me. Especially young men, they all think that. That's all. I just live, Yah, eat, Yah, you liar. I will, because if you're doing that, there's a verse in Shirak. You can tell the spirit of a man by the expression of joyfulness upon his face. So we delight in the Torah of Yah, right? So if you're meditating that way, then you're going to tell that upon your countenance. You tell much between here and here of a man. I know what he's about. That's how far I need to look. I don't need to look in the history or his past. I don't give a damn. Hallelujah. He says here, Yisrael, that no man is going to be able to buy or to sell unless he receive the mark of the beast. Look at Eob here in verse 14, chapter 10.
He says to Yah, Eob 10, verse 14, this is a complaint now. It's a complaint of great agony. He has all, he is really venting his frustration here. And this is what he says to Yah. He said, if I sin, then you mock me. If I sin, Yah, you mock me. Eob 10, 14. He said, if I sin, then you mock me. He said, you will not acquit me from my iniquity. Who is this one that is coming? Is he not coming with all wickedness and iniquity? Is that not the one? Hallelujah. Let me turn here. If I sin, he says to Yah, you mock me. You have marked me. You have Shemai. You have guarded me. You have put me in that position for a purpose. Hallelujah. I want to make a few things clear to us today, Yisrael. Hallelujah. I don't even know how I'm going with this, but it's going to go one way or the other. Is that all right? Hallelujah. It might as well be all right because it makes no difference. Whether you buy it or not, it makes me no different. Whether you love me, whether you care for me, makes me no different. We have all been deceived. No, I haven't. Man, your own heart deceives you. Heart is deceitful above all things and is desperately wicked. All the ways of a man, they're pure. They're tahor, clean and right at his own sight. But Yah ponders, he weighs, he balances the ruach and the flesh. He says he's a boy. She's a little girl. She does. She's silly. I send my messenger. Talk to her. Teach. He says, if I sin, he says, Yah, look at this now. Why would he say this? You will not acquit me from my ovon. Shaul speaks to us. You must understand. You must have line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little, there a little. And everyone does not possess the mastery of Torah and the skills to do that. That's a fact. That's a fact. An 18-year-old lad coming out of college, playing basketball in NBA with someone like LeBron James, 19 years, whose body has developed, he cannot stay with him. That's why the National Football League will not let, unless you serve 2 years in college, they will not, because they know that your body is not even ready for the rigor. That's a fact. So you must do 2 years in college, and one clown thought he could sue, didn't have nothing but a lawyer, and they got all that money, and he has never played in the league, really, since day one. So there are things that it takes the mastery, a spiritual nurturing to mature and to build one mind for you even to ascertain, to understand. These young cats today, they read a few scriptures. They know every damn thing. Well, I'm going to question the real. Don't come to me with no questions, boy. You better listen. Your questions are silly. I get questions all the time. I say, I'm not going to even answer that. I'm not going to even ask that stupid question. It's stupid. They have no relativity to one's growth, one's spiritual strength. They just think that they may know something you don't know. That's the truth. And don't challenge me that way. All right? Don't do that. Hallelujah. I don't care who you are. I'm telling you that. Don't do it with me. You do it with them other clowns. But don't come here with that. Hallelujah. Look at this in Thessalonica, 2 Thessalonica, chapter 2. Shaul says, first of all, verse 2. Listen to what he says. Now, this is where it all begins. Chapter 2, verse 2. He says, I want you to understand. Let me read verse 1. Now I beg of you, Ma'ach, by the bow of the entering into the atmosphere of the coming in your bosom and your mind, the coming of our HaMashiach, Yeshua, and by the gathering together us unto him. Now he tells them that you be not so soon shaken in mind. That's where it all begins, in the Labba. Don't be shaken or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter of word, as from us as the day of Yeshua, the day of Yah, is at hand. Don't let it trouble you. When you see the great agony and the suppression arising, don't let that trouble you, Yisrael. Don't be baffled by that. Don't
allow it to bother you. And then he said, let no man deceive you. What man? First of all, it is the hidden man of your own heart. That is what deceive all men, their own hidden man of their own heart. Because they will tell you, I'm a man like you. Well, then you're not much of a damn man if you're like me. I'm a man like Yeshua HaMashiach. If you tell me that, then you will get my attention. You tell me you're a man like me, you're not worth a damn then. Because if you equate yourself in the quality of your strength to me, then you're not much of a man then. Hallelujah. Fact, you're a little boy. Just like a little boy saying, I'm a man, you boy. As is a man, you boy. Zeria got hurt. She's getting old. Her teeth pulled, you know, it's that time. So I called Hadassah, you know, she came to me crying and said, Papi, look, and she's tender as cotton candy. And so I said, Hava, she's like wrought iron. She'll probably say, give me the pliers. Move out of the room. I got it. Of course, I said, the Seria, I called her, snag the wag. She got a wide gate there. So she looks at me the other day and she says, Papi, do like this. She says, see there, look at you. You're just as snag as I am. I said, no, look, girl, this is how this has grown back when all my. She said, you call me snaggy wag. Look at that. Look, do like, smile like me. See me? Now you smile. That's all right then. I can't call you snaggy waggy anymore, huh? That's just my space between my teeth. I just got a gap. And I was not going to get it closed, get no bracelets, and get it closed. Not me. Hallelujah. Listen to this here quickly. I want to read a few things in close tonight. This evening, Zachin will come. Let no man deceive you, for the day shall not come except that first come. What a falling away. Who's this letter to? This is to the scattered Israelites throughout the nations. Oh, they say Gentile. Well, that's what we are. Well, what does the word Gentile? The word Gentile or heathens. In the Hebrew, it is goyim. Goyim. Just nations. Just nations. When Yah talks about specifically his people, he called them Am. Like A-M. Am. Nation. Not only is a nation, but it's a nation of collective of people of the 12 tribes of Israel. Not just Yehuda being separated here and Ephraim here. That's not what he means. It's the collection of his people. And so we are just like Gentiles. We do what the Gentiles do. We act like them. We act like the heathens. We're heathens toward each other. The world doesn't give a damn about nobody. And we don't give a damn about each other. So we acted just like them. Our inspiration is some whore dressed like a dirty slut like a dog. Some effeminate man wearing some tight blue jeans that he can barely move in. And we call that fashion. Well, mama, you just keep making my clothing, all right? I like the way you do that, okay? But yet we call it fashion. He said, it cannot happen except that come a falling away. Yisrael will fall away. There's going to be a Bahia remnant. And that the matter of Sim revealer, whom the son, he is the son perditioned. He is spiritually damned. He has no conscience of Yah. He betrays Yah. And that mark, just like Yehuda Iscariot, did not Yeshua said, I have chosen 12 of you. And what is a dumb devil? Did he say that? He said it. He knew it was the devil. He was the son of perdition. Because Kitvei Torah must be fulfilled. He gives us an example. Look, drop down to verse 7. I sin, as Eob said, and you will not acquit my iniquity. It says in verse 7, for the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now let will let. Until he be taken out of the way, then that wicked one shall be revealed, whom Yeshua shall consume with the ruach of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. You see what Eob said? He said, for if I sinned, then you mark me. So the one of iniquity is already marked. Was not the son of perdition already marked? Did Yahuda have a mark on his forehead say, look, I'm the perdition baby. This is a stupid generation. He had a mind that was damnable and twisted of God's Yah. And people think that, I'm not let, come on man, you might as well just shoot me dead now. He did not say they would demand. It will not be what is in prison. He had said it will cause all to receive the mark. So you might as well put the cap in me, baby. Drop me now. No, but how does the logistics play out? How do you go in the boonies of the land? He calls every man. Call all. How does the logistics pan out? If the infrastructure is brought down to hell, you think if they drop bombs on Russia that they're not going to drop bombs on their major metroplex and the cities? That's the first thing that Mr. Bush did, the dirty bastard, when he went there to Iraq, stop bombing the infrastructure, the roads and stuff like that. And they still don't have logistics there. And so you have this cataclysmic mayhem. Where are the logistics for that? This is so stupid, Yisrael. But people buy that. What is the word I'm looking for? It is the word that help me, Yah. Theatrics. That's not the word I'm looking for. Yeah, come on, Zachin, help me. They love drama. People love drama. It's like the news reporter called me from Columbia University. Said, we want to do an interview with you. I said, look, my friend, if you're coming here for drama, you might as well take that somewhere else. If you want to understand a people and their lifestyles, that is not going to sell. No, I'm looking for truth. We're looking for that. I said, but if you're coming for drama, how did you find out about me? Someone is passing out leaflets of you and your website, and that's why I call you. So they thought that I was what they thought was one of those, say, damn America, but I do say damn America. Just like Mr. Jeremiah Wright. Damn this wicked nation. That bruise the backs of those that have no back to even bruise. And then they tell them, pull yourself up by your bootstrap when they're barefooted. How does one pull themselves up when they have no boots on? That is right. It is only Micaiah, the Melach of Yah. And his name implies, who is like Yah? I like that. Nobody like him. That shall be the mantra of the system. Who is like unto this beast? And who is able to make war with him? Who was able to make war with this most diabolical machine we call Christendom? Tell me, who is able to make war with this whore called Catholicism? She brings down governments. That's what she does. She is the only religion that has the identity and the mark of a nation. And she has a seat in the General Assembly of the United Nations. She's nothing but a damn religion. How can that be? It cannot be. She's not a nation. She's not a nation. She's a whore. And we see all of all the whorish Christian daughters that promenade in their damn Jesus. And I don't care what anyone say, they birth that spirit. They're of this whore. She lays with anyone. She will lay with the Muslims. She will lay with the Buddhists. She will lay with those that call themselves Hebrews. She will lay with Jews. She is a nida, dirty whore. She doesn't even change the rag when she comes on her monthly. That's a funky, wicked, dirty hoe. She's a spiritual retard. And these creeps out here, they love her dirty blood. And they don't want the dam of Yahshua HaMashiach. Yeah, I'm bold and brazen. Damn Jesus. And I won't stop saying it. Hallelujah. So if Yah marked me and you will not acquit my iniquity, we know that one that is of iniquity, they're already marked.
Their mind is Russia. It is a mind that is an enemy of Almighty Yah. If we are carnal minded, for the carnal mind is enmity against the Torah of Yah. It cannot be subject unto that because it is spiritual. It is spiritual. The Torah is spiritual. And so the natural mind cannot comprehend the Torah of Yah. And so this mark is beyond some chip, Israel. Let no one deceive you with that. It's beyond that. And a matter of fact, everyone teach that, and they will say, quote, God told me, he spoke to me. You liar, you read the book, man. You went on the internet, you did a research, and you search out the internet. You all heard me that were listening last night when I was talking to Akhriman. I say, okay, let's just, 10, 12 years ago, you look up the word, yeah, it was only 14,000 writings on the 14 at the max. Now there are 155 million. Every schoolborn, every pot boy, as he said, if everyone could read this Torah, he said, then every schoolborn, every pot boy would think that he knows everything. Even the illiterate think they know. One writes me, his name is not Yah, his name is Yahweh. I say, your ignorance is appalling. You're a jackass. And so there's this brother, he defends me. He said, man, why are you, in essence, what he said, why are you messing with Riyak? What you need to do is listen to hear what he's saying, what you need to do. I write the man back and say, your ignorance is appalling. Your stupidity is pronounced. I say, go to our website. It's www.yahwehsword. It's just young, stupid, retarded individuals. That's what they are. They're stupid. Oh, they come with somebody, they think they know everything. I've never operated like that. I like to sit back and be quiet and see and hear. A wise man, he will hear. And he will become wiser. But a fool will always speak what's on his mind. Well, brother, I want to challenge you with that. Don't challenge me. All right. You don't have the wherewithal to challenge me. So if this iniquity is marked, if Micaiah, the one that held back this spirit from inundating Yisra'ya and the nations of the earth, then there's a mark, isn't it? Let me show a perfect example. Let me turn here. Hold up, Yisra'ya, to Yeskel, to the book of Ezekiel. I want to show you something. Ezekiel, chapter 9. There are many times I wake up in the morning. I always get up early on Shabbat. I can't lay there. Yom Kippur, I said, I'm going to sleep till 8. Well, 6, my eyes were wide open. So I say to my Isha, you might as well get up. You know you can't lay here. She said, watch me. And so I'm trying to lie in bed, 7 rolls around. I said, I can't stand this. I can't handle this anymore. I'm out of here. I'm up, and that's it. I cannot lay there. Although I would love to have stayed there to 8 or 9, I can't do it. I don't care if I go to bed at 1 a.m. in the morning. I can't do it. I said, I got to get up out of here. I was getting tired just laying there. I couldn't sleep. As much to this, but I wanted to refresh our minds today. Let me close with this here from the book of Yeskel, chapter 9, Ezekiel. As he sees the great mayhem that shall come upon Yisra'el because of our unfaithfulness and disobedience, Yah has always raised up nations as his sword. The wicked is the sword of Yah to bring correction to his nation and his people. So he cries unto Yeskel, the Nobi, the prophet, for instructions in his house among his people. It says here in Yeskel, Ezekiel chapter 9, verse 1. He said, and he kara also in my ear with a loud, cold voice, saying, this is what I want you to do. I want you to cause them to have charge of the city to draw near. Every man with his destroying weapon, the tool of death,
This is y'all talking to Yeskel, is it not?
Sure is.
And he says to him, and behold, six men came from the way of the higher gate that lies towards the north. All of this is of great importance. The northern kingdom, the southern kingdom, and every man a slaughtering weapon in his hand. Every man had a weapon of death, of destruction. And listen to this. And one among them was clothed in bad. That's what linen is, bad. In my days, they would say he's bad to the bone. When someone was dressed, they would say he's bad, man. He's bad to the bone. They didn't know what they were saying. But one that was dressed in linen, the fine linen of Yah. Listen to this one. Look at him. Not all of them were dressed that way, but there was one. Yahushua marks the mind of Yisrael. He is the mark, that testimony. He had a writer's inkhorn by his side. And he went, not everyone stood beside the brazen altar. He went and he stood beside the brazen altar of Yah, and the chabot, the splendor, the beauty, the tiferah, the beauty of Yah, of Yisrael, was gone up from the cherub when he stood before the altar. And it caused all heaven, Hashemaim, to move. The honor and the beauty, the fragrance of Yah went up. Whereupon he was. There's only one that has that pure anointing. His name is Yahushua HaMashiach. He is the one with the writer's inkhorn. He is the one that marks Tav. He is the one that marks Yisrael. And no man is going to be able to buy or to sell. You're not going to redeem yourself. If he doesn't mark you, you're not being redeemed, Yisrael. If he doesn't put your name in his shop, in his bosom, you're not going to be redeemed. Listen to this. We have ignorant men. These are boys. You shall not give that which is wise and powerful unto babes. They're not strong enough. They can't handle it. I've watched people come here. Sometimes the ark, we're in the gym, they've never lift weights a day in their life, and all of a sudden they see this ark racking down all them pounds on his chest, and they literally think they can do it. I say, no, you're silly, you're going to kill yourself. That fall off on you, you're going to be in trouble. No, 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 I can't have them suing us. We don't have no insurance or nothing here. You ever done that? Oh, I used to. When? 30 years ago? Man, stop that. Not realizing that this man does that every day. Because you see him pick up 400 plus pounds, that means you're going to pick that. You are so silly. You're going to break your back. You're going to, not only are you going to have a pulled muscle, you're going to have some of everything wrong with you. I look at it and say, man, that's all right, boy. Just let me, that's how stupid this generation is. So they see a messenger of Yah, they think, oh, I got what he got. No, you don't. No, you don't. So when this one that was dressed in the bath and the linen, it says that it saw this beauty of Yah, it just resonated whereupon he was to the threshold of the bed. And he called to the man, not the men, but the man clothed with linen, which had the writer's inkhorn by his side. Now, can I ask you a question? You think you could go through Jefferson and say, look, I want to put a mark on your forehead to say that Yah is going to kill you. You say, hold up, dog. No, dog, we ain't going that way, dog. What's up, player? What? You going what? Man, I bang you. Come on. Hey, you're a fool. You going to go to a Muslim and say that? Come on, Yisrael, we're silly. We think we're smart. In our own conceit, we're dumb. All of Yisrael, his people are sottish. We're dumb. And Yah said unto him, go through the midst of the city, throughout the midst of Yerushalayim, and set a mark upon the foreheads of them, the men, the ish, those that have the physical aptitude of Yah, the strength, the masculinity, the power. Yah doesn't intend for the men to walk around like some feeble, immature, impotent individual. And that's just the truth. Have no courage in Torah, no strength of Torah. He said, you set a mark on the men that sigh and cry for all of the abomination, the to'eba, the filthiness, a sin that be done in the midst thereof. But a man doesn't cry against that, he's not a messenger of Yah. Because we are in the cauldron of all kinds of abomination and every kind of to'eba, every kind of iniquitous work is taking place. What a man, he must cry against. And that man has the mark of Yah. He has the mark of Yah. He has the testimony of the power of Yahshua in his heart, in his mind. That's why that one that had the writer's ink on, he was different than the other ones, you understand. And when he stood by the brazen altar of Yah, because in him are the offerings offered unto Yah. We saw the beauty of Yah. And it's no telling what all happened there. We got enough. If we can't believe this, we will not bleed. If he detail it out, it would take 1,000 pages to detail it out. And you don't read these pages, you're not going to read the 1,000. All right? And because you think you read the Torah, that doesn't mean anything. You can read novels. I read history. I used to read a book every week. That was my motive. Every week, I read a new book. I would read a book every week. Every week. It may have taken me a little longer. Some books, it depends, but I would read a book. My favorite thing on Friday, when I was off from work at that time, my issue and I go to the bookstore. I like bookstores. She didn't like that, but I did. Most people want to go to Walmart, Dollar Mart, and Kmart. I wanted to go to the bookstore. I find books and I buy them. Sometimes I walk out of there with 10, 12 books. And I have $20 in it back then. Wow. Maybe old books, but that's all right. I would buy them. There's only one book of passion. I don't need historical books. I don't read stuff like that. I read this. And I don't read it on the hark. I study. That I do not get out of line with what Yah commands as a king. That's why Shaul said to Shaul, why he said to Timothy, study, boy, lahak, to show yourself approved unto Yah. As a workman, you need not to be ashamed. That you rightly divide the word. You're not doing that in the sense that you just can't rebuke an elder. You don't walk upon that elder, Zachin, Obadiah, Yisrael, that has been laboring in Torah for 75 years. And you go to tell him what? He said, stop it, boy. He said, don't. He said, now, see, they'll despise your youth if you act like that, boy. And that's what everybody says, study to show yourself approved. Well, how can you get the calculus like him unless you understand the elementaries of all of the other mathematical formulas? How do you do that? How do you get the physics? And I'm not talking about understand. You got to understand the finite and the details of that. How do you understand Einstein relativity? Theory of relativity? You can't. And this is greater than his theory. Yah made light. Period. That's right. Moving quickly. He says, and to the others he said in my hearing, listen now, I want you to go after him through the city. And he said, I want you to kill. I want you to muth. I want you to kill, to smite. He said, listen now, is this Yah, is this the Yah you know? He said, let not your eyes, hoots, don't spare, have no pity, no care. He said, neither do I want you to have chamal, to have any kind of compassion. He said, I want you to kill, damn it, kill them. We don't want to hear Yah talking like that, do we? He said, kill the grandmammy, kill all. He said, kill all. Oh, mama was 92. We know she went to heaven. Mama went in the grave, honey. He said, damn their gods. He said, go through. I want you to go mock those. The mock of Yah, the Shema. That means to guard them. I want you to put a hedge about them. Just like when the enemy, did Eob have a mark? But yet he said, Yah marked him, didn't he? When the enemies, he says unto Yah, you know I can't touch him because you have a hedge. And that's what the word Shema means. It is a hedge of thorns. He said, you can't nobody touch Eob, you know that. He said, but pull it down. And I'll make him cuss you out to your face. I'll make him curse you. Challah.
Yeah, I said, all right, devil, but you can't touch that breath. Now, you know I'm not going to let you put your hands on me, boy, because I will skin you to pieces. I made you. Yeah, I'm bringing it down, getting real with you, all right? He said, damn it, kill them all. Quote, oh, God is love. The Lord Jesus Christ would never. Oh, he full of hatred. Did he say kill them all?
Yes.
You can dress it up any way you want to. He said, damn it, start with the old heads. They're wicked as hell. They stubborn as hell. They hard-headed as hell. Say, kill them all. Kill all. Kill all. Slay all. Destroy all. And young. And young. Both made. And this is always, he used when you see little children, it is the word taf. T-A-F. A taf is like that little baby him and his Ishaw just had. That's still sucking on the teddy. He's grown up to a glass of water now. Huh? That would be a taf. Little ones like Zippia, that's taf. He said, damn it, kill them all. Kill all. Kill the young ones. Come on. Kill them all. Listen to me. Kill them all. He said, the taf, the little children. He said, and the wicked women, kill them all. Women, but come not near any man who is marked. He said, I want you to begin at my tabernacle, at my Beit HaMikdash. If judgment be got in the house of Yah, where shall the wicked and the sinners appear before Yah? His judgment shall be gotten. He said, I begin in my house. Huh? Then they began at the Ancient of Men. He said, kill all those old bastards. Yah's not playing. He said, kill them all. They have defiled my truth. They have robbed. They have laid with the daughters of Kizion. They have taken advantage of them. They have seen this woman in a feeble state. She has no strength to fight him off. He has monies. He has the big fine car. He take advantage of her vulnerability. That's nothing but a damn dog. If you're going to do it, man, go out in the street and get your flat out hole that got game. You don't take advantage of a daughter of Tizayon. You go find your hoe that got game, that play game. She can roil, she can toil, she can battle like you. And she can talk the same talk you talk. You don't take advantage of a vulnerable daughter of Tizayon, you dirty bastard. Give me a flat out whore. Whether I get AIDS or not, give me that. You don't plead a daughter of Tizayon. I despise that damn spirit. Give me a hoe. No, I'm not going to try to fantasize with the virgin. Give me a hoe. A real hoe. Give me a hoe. Not a whore, but a hoe. You get my talk. I'm not going to fancy up my language. You take a vulnerable child of Bethula for your twisted fantasies like that, man out there in California. He's on a $2 million bond. And Joaquin Charles Davis sent me newspapers. He sent me a whole bundle of newspapers from Los Angeles. And in the article, the surprising thing about this man was, this is what was said. Nobody knows him. We thought we knew, but nobody knew him. An attractive wife, you're taking advantage of a 14-year-old child? You are a twisted retard, man. You are a boy. You're stupid. I don't have no sympathy for anyone like that. Let him stay in jail. Under the true Torah of Yah, he would have died. And if she didn't cry out, kill the little whore. Kill her too. Hallelujah. He said, began with these old silly men. They're like the cloud. He said unto them, he said, defile, nida. Make it bloody. Defile the house and fill the court with the slain. Go forth
And they went forth and they killed in the city. And it came to pass while they were slaying them, I was left. This is Yeska. He said, I was left by myself. And I fell upon my knee, my face, and I cried, will you destroy Israel? You just don't know what we have. Look at what he cried out. He fell down, Yeska, and he cried, will you destroy all the residue of Yisrael, the remnant? Will you destroy the remnant by pouring out your fury upon Yerushalayim? Then Yah said to me, the iniquity, the ovon, the transgressing of the Torah of the house of Beit Yisrael and Yehuda is exceedingly great. And the land is full of sin, full of blood. And the city full of perverseness, every kind of wickedness, every kind of mind is marked by wickedness. That's the mind of this sadistic mind against Yah. And you're not going to have any ease under the system of the kingdom power of hell unless you give allegiance unto the powers of darkness. He said, and Yah, he says, for they say, Yah have forsaken the earth, and Yah doesn't even see us. And as for me also, my eyes, Yah says this. He says, my eyes, I want you to understand, shall not spare. Neither will I have chamah, pity, but I will repay them their ways upon their, you see where the mark is going? Upon what? Their head. In the right hand, their strength, their yata, or in their forehead. And what does the forehead represent? The laba. He said, I'm going to repay them for the mark that's in their forehead. Parents could look at the children's forehead and say that. You can see death on that child. He's got a mark on him, baby. Let's just pray. Oh, I used to hear them say that. And it says this, and behold, your shoe. I know what he said. The man clothed with bad in linen, which had the inkhorn by his side, reported the matter, saying, I have done as you have, Savai, you commanded me. I've done just what you said. He said, I'm going to kill the babies and all. But let me read this and close with this. One last thing, your assurance, Yisrael. And I'm going to get back on this teaching. Zochain, the app will be teaching next week. I'm not preaching. I may get up and just say one word of encouragement, but that will be it. Quickly, Jeremiah chapter 31 is one thing that we know, Yisrael, that Yah, he's going to be the Abba of the families of Yisrael, as it said in Jeremiah 31 verse 1. I want to speak from verse 7, just three verses here before I close. For this says Yah, he tells us to ranan, to sing out, to cry out. It shall be an overexcitement of joy. He said, I want you to do it with simcha, sing with gladness, Yisrael, for Yaakov, and shout among the chief of the nations. He said, I want you to publish or to sing hallel, send hallelujah, and say, oh Yah, deliver the people. Listen, the remnant of Yisrael. Did not Yeskel say, you're going to destroy the residue, the remnant of Yisrael? Verse 8, Yah says, behold, I will bring them from the north country. Who's going to do it? Yah. He said, I'm going to bring them from the north, and I will gather them from the coast of the earth. He said, with them shall be the blind and the lame, the women and the child, the woman and the child, and her that travail with her child together. He said, a great company shall return here. Then shall they shall come with bechi, with weeping, and with supplication. And with supplication will I leave them. And look what he's going to do. He says, I'm going to cause them to walk by the Nachal, or the rivers of waters of Yarsha of Strait. That's where he's going to cause us to walk, Yisrael. He that bleeds on the name of Almighty Yah, in Yeshua HaMashiach, as the Torah has said, and we believe on that. Hallelujah. Out of our betim, out of our belly shall flow rivers of the living water. Hallelujah. He's going to bring us to the river of straits.
of strength of Yeshua.
That's what he's going to bring us to the bosom of Yeshua HaMashiach. He's going to bring us to the river of strength. And look at this, to the straight way, wherein, Yah says, we shall not stumble, we're not going to fall. We come to this living water, and we know what the living water is, and Dawid tells us there in Tehillim Psalms 1, we shall be like the tree planted by the rivers of water. He said, you shall not stumble, for I am the Abba of Yisrael and Ephraim, my firstborn. And we know Ephraim is the second son of Yosef, that he said the blessings not to Manasseh, but to you. Hallelujah. We have come after the first son, have we not? Yeshua. And that's why he declared, these works I do, greater shall you do. I am going to stop, period. May the riches of Yah rest upon you, all I do. Pray that Yah grants us wisdom and understanding in the simplicity of Torah. I didn't go in the way I wanted to concerning the mark, but that's all right. One of the art will pick it up from there. You got enough to refresh your mind in that and to keep going, Yisrael. It's more than just a literal mark in our heads. You understand? Because there are not too many people going to allow someone. That's why we have a system that is methodical. It's developing the minds to receive every kind of ill and will action and attitude that's against Yah. Everybody is right. Everybody. Nobody forbears one another. Everybody is right. Everybody knows everything. That's almost like my little babies. They tell me, Papa, you know that? Especially this one. She can read now, and you can't tell her nothing. I'm reading something. It's, oh, what is that? Okay, What does that mean? I said, if I tell you what you understand, she will not understand. So I don't take time to tell her. Well, that's not how you do it. No, there are things that are too heavy for her. Yeah. When I tell her to lift 100 pounds, she can't do it. I'll lift 100 pounds for her. And you just walk behind me, little girl. All right? And that's what we do. Yeshua has, he has made his burden easy. His yoke is easy and his burden is light, isn't it? Because we couldn't bear it. We can't even bear what we encounter today, can we? All right then. We'll leave it at that. So we greet you all again that have joined us, the few. We'll be gathered here on Monday evening as we began Yom Sukkah. Looking for a wonderful time. We're going to sing and dance and eat. We're going to eat. We're going to eat a lot too. That's the beauty of it. You get to eat and you don't have to feel ashamed. Well, I may gain weight, but that's all right. Don't worry about the weight gaining. We're going to have a great time and a wonderful time. So we greet you all, you that come join us. Come, as I say, to all women, do not wear pants. Don't show everybody your little skinny legs. Nobody needs to see that. You have no assurance and you have no confidence. That's why you want to show yourself off. No man needs to see your titties. Cover your titties. Cover your titties, all right? Cover your titties. Cover yourself. We know you're fine as long as you think it. They'll come there. And don't come here, my friend, with some kind of little tank top on, man. It's short pants. We don't do that, all right? We just don't go that way. Yeah. Well, I'm muscular. Well, okay, then. You just be muscular. Don't worry about it. Come here and do a little work. We'll break the muscles down. How about that? We get you on one of those trees out there and picking up that oak. I'd rather roof all day than to pick that stuff up. We got to do something so I can't do in the cold months. That's heavy. That's heavy. You go over there early in the morning when they unload one of those trailers and throwing that stuff off, you're like, man, this, I'm not picking it. You grab that in, I grab this in. You put that up there like that? Neat and stacked. Now, you grab that in. And I can't bend over like that. I got to go down like that. Like, oh, no, your little knees get a little tight. They get a little old, so you just don't. Come on. So I don't mind painting and working in the garden and any of that for their faithfulness. There was a time this place was full. Look at it. There was a time that Yisrael was the blossom of Yah's eye. Look at Yisrael today.
This is the metaphor, not us. This is the true reality of Israel, a few. The wayfaring man, every now and then on the highway of God, you find one. That's it. You find a tremendous amount of people that are religious and arrogant. You find that today. YouTube has made everybody a star. YouTube has made everybody a star. YouTube has made everybody a star. Facebook, all of that. I was very reluctant to put our stuff on there, but I know, I heard from a family yesterday say, my Isha and I, we found you on YouTube, and we have been listening. Can we come visit? I said, sure. You all can come and visit. Hallelujah. I've worked with men in Atlanta, and they all proved to be what? Shallow and weak. Because they want to be great. They don't have no power to work. They're not willing to work. And they all want to compare themselves with me. They can't do what I do, not even physically. They can't roll with me working. And the fact of the matter, they're all younger than me. Except one. They can't roll with me in no work. Nah, they can't roll. They cannot roll with me. Old man Bishop Banks, he worked until he died. He said, I'm an oak tree. That old man, he worked, man, every day. And he did not procrastinate. He didn't play around. You work with me, boy, you're going to work. That's right. Get who it was. So if I go, I'd rather drop like Matthew said. I'd rather drop in the hayfield. You won't know when you drop nowhere. You just drop, and that's it. Maggots immediately. They begin to say, ah, baby, we can feed on this. That's the truth. And you're gone, period. So we don't fear that. That's the reality of life. I'm not going to waste my energy upon the wind. I'm going to die. I'm going to work until I die. And so when I die, I die. And as they always say, let the works I do speak for me. Let my testimony. You understand Yisrael? One of the things that Yah gave us to produce health and wealth and everything, He gave us work. The sweat of our panim, our face. We should sweat in our face. When a man does sweat in his face, then there's poison in him. Okay, who he is. I'm not talking about going out running and all that work. Working. We sweat that way. Work. That's what it means. I don't give a damn if you get upset, you don't like it, you say, you're talking to me, I'm talking to you. Can I say this before I close? I remember when young man, I was in the school there. Company Duke Energy wanted to hire me. They wanted to hire me for graphics design. They wanted to send me to school in Atlanta for 6 months. I said, I've gone with my woman for 6 months. Go to no school. You're crazy. Because there was a lot of money back then. I would have been making a lot of money. I said, I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that. So they were really trying to really recruit minorities, as they would say. You understand? So they write me again and say, look, since you don't want that job, I mean, I had a job there. We'll hire you as a linesman. You know, we'll teach you that. You don't want to do that. We'll hire you as a linesman. We didn't have many people of the diaspora, of the dark hue skin working there at that time. And I thought about that. I said, well, you know, I was religious. I wouldn't say religious, but, you know, going to church when I could, the church. I said, man, those cats work all the time. Storm come through, they work 15, 16 hours straight. I ain't about to do that. Of course, the job I had wasn't making no money when I was in school at that time. I said, nah, I don't want that. Boy, you may work 10, 12, 15 hours. You may have to go to Atlanta to work. You may have to go some of the other subsidiaries. No, tell them where you may have to go. You may go on for weeks. And I said, no, And they were persistent in their pursuing them. I said, no, I'm not going there. I'm glad that y'all had me that way. So I wasn't making much money. So many y'all say, well, you know, we just barely... You know, the money just ain't that tough. So I said, okay. So I went to IBM and filled out an application. When I filled the application out, my penmanship, I've always had, I can design all kinds of letters. I've always been able to. My penmanship was so, it was so right that the next day they called me. And the person said, it was your penmanship that your application stood out from among all applications. It's the hand of God. Well, I said when I went there, I said, I'm going to work 5 years in that, and I'm quitting. I'm not going to, I don't want to get no promotion, nothing, because And so I worked 10 years there. And one day I said, that's it. And I just walked in and quit. I came home that day. My manager said, "You're crazy." I'll never forget his words. These are his words. Quote, "These bastards don't give a damn about nobody, but they like you." That's how he said it. He said, "These bastards don't care for nobody. They like you, man." They knew my wife because she would come to the job at times. She wasn't working. She'd come, have lunch with me or something like that. And they knew, all my managers knew my wife. So he says to me, "Go home." He said, "Go home and talk to Jean like she's going to change something." And it was one of the most beautiful spring days you won't look at. I said, "I know what I'm going to do, Jim." He said, "Man, no. Go home and talk to her. Let her know. You talk to her first." And when I left, it was about 9:30 that morning. He said, "You leave now. No, don't worry about nothing. You just go home." That's what he told me. I said, "Well, this is a pretty day." I said, "Mama, we go out and I don't know if we went to Grady's or somewhere. We went out and had something to eat. Not something, but something." And that was it. And once I said that, everything left my heart, even the bill. I don't care, they're going to pay me $100,000 a year. And I'm not boasting. I was making more money than people with college degrees. They've been there 25 years. And I know what I'm saying, because my managers trusted me. They knew. They would tell me things they would tell nobody. They would show me stuff they would not tell anyone. I don't know why they did it, but they did. They were saying, "If you say anything about it, I say you lied. And you know if I say that, what's going to happen, they're going to fire you." But they were showing. I say, "Come on, you know me. It's between you and me. You trust me like that? You think I would?" No. I had managers go to bat. "You don't see what I got you, man? See how much raise I got you?" I remember one saying, "You're very observant. You don't see that man on a man, I put my sticks out your head." He didn't use that term, but he said, man, "You're very observant. And I put this before you, and you don't see that. You don't see what I've done for you." That's okay. I didn't want to say anything. I just, I wanted to be quiet. "It's all right." He said, "What's it bad for you?" Wow, you know why they did that? Because I would work. I didn't cheat them out of the time. I didn't take advantage of nothing. I did right. And that's the way we do before Yah. We do. No, I'm not. Damn David. Damn him as a person. He has no value. You understand? When Yah puts something in our bosom, we don't even understand what we're doing, but it's to bring about honor unto him. And that's what I do. So as I worked as working unto Yah, that men would see the labor of Yah in me. They will see our tough works. You understand? And they will ask us for a reason. Why do we operate that way? Because of Yahshua HaMashiach. Yabarak you all. We look forward to the Mo'adim with you all. May Yabarak you Azakin. Yarama Yah, may the riches of Yah rest upon you. Come on, Azakin. We have the mic on up here for you. Hallelujah. That's all right. You're all right. Hallelujah. May Yabarak Yisrael and his strength on you.
Sure. Hallelujah. Let us walk in truth, Israel, above all things. It'll take us all the way to the end. The ways of this world, they don't walk in truth, Israel. They don't abide in truth. And what you see a nation that is crumbling. The things that they have hope in, it's all crumbling. It's not going to last. Only the Torah, the truth, is going to last, Israel. So let us put all of our hope, our conscience, our mind, our time, and the mishvah and the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. And it will take us through into the end, Israel. Yeah. Hallelujah. Let us stand to our feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I brought Yahweh that I marked today. Hallelujah. By the Dama Yahshua HaMashiach. One fact that I heard years ago concerning crime scenes or accidents, they said that the blood never washes away. It's always there. It may not be visual to the eyes, but the blood is always there. The Dama Yahshua has been shed for Yisrael. And even though we may not see it, Yisrael, it is there, it is alive, it is powerful, and it's still cleansing, it washes us from all of our iniquities. Hallelujah. The blood of Yahshua HaMashiach is still alive, and so is he. Hallelujah. Abba Yahweh, you do barak you for the Shabbaton. We barak you, Yahweh, for the rest. For truly, Yahweh, you have fed us this day. It was able to rest in the assurance of your Torah, the sure foundation, the rock of Yisrael. And all things we barak you, we do ask that you would take those home that have traveled from near and afar safely, and that your Melekim will continually be encamped around Yisrael, just as your Torah encamp Yob Yahweh. Encamp around us, Yahweh. Protect us and keep us. And all things we do barak you in the precious and mighty name of Yahshua HaMashiach, we do pray. Hallelujah. 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 Yahweh. 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 Yahwe